Hey everyone, I'm here at our new house in California. This is a flowering plum tree, and so that means it doesn't bear fruit, it just looks beautiful. But whatever happened with this guy does not even look like a tree. So I sculpt trees, I have done this since I was a little kid, and this tree needs a massive haircut. This is like getting rid of dreadlocks. So just probably a quarter into the work here. And this is our beautiful Fuji apple tree. Excited about that. Now out here in Campo, just about everybody has these propane tanks. So that's what you'll see. It's cheaper than electricity, so that's what we have. So this is our beautiful home. And we'll come up here to the front door. And I'll show you inside.
I'm voicing over this part because Gal is sleeping in the other room and I don't want to wake him up. So this is our little front entryway. And then you saw the rabbit hutch here. This is where Rapels is. There he is. He's looking to see if I have a treat right now, and I don't, so he's starting to get suspicious. Because you never know what I'm gonna do. Take him out and brush him or trim his nails or something horrible like that. Yep, no treat. He's immediately suspicious. Silly little guy. He does love a cheek rub though. And then through here is our office, and most of the packing that we haven't gotten to yet is in this room as well. It's a lot of boxes, but we've gotten through so many. This is not much left. It's really nice. This is the boys' bathroom, so everything's nicely set up for them. They've got everything they need, even their fun little towels. And in here is the boys' room. Andred's bed is there. And then Galahad is asleep right here with all his fun little toys. They have their arsenal here. There's so many weapons in there, it's funny. And then Galahad's side of the closet, and then Andrew's side. Still have so many pictures to hang, and so much to do still. I still want to put curtains right here so you don't have to see the clothes in the hangers, but we'll see what happens, and take the wood off of that wall. But they have a nice little reading nook here, a place to sit, the toys underneath. That's Andred's old bassinet with all his stuffed animals in there, and a look out into the side for the backyard. And garage entrance and coat closet / pantry.
Alright, and then turning into here, we've got some nice storage and a cubby hole of stuff right now that has not been organized. And this is our bedroom. And that ceiling fan just does not go in the room, so I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna put in there instead. Dog crates, more stuff to unpack. My vanity over there. The backyard. I'm painting up so far. And the dresser. This is the bathroom. And we're going to be redoing the paint in here and the paint in there. So the paint in here is going to be like a very soft sandy tan. And in here, I haven't decided what the base paint is going to be. It's either going to be white or a very soft aqua or the same sand color with mostly silver and then gold on it. I should probably turn on the light so you can actually see. So it's going to all be neutral metallic. amongst this mess hiding are my lanterns. This is the base to one. So it hangs up like that. And I want to put that one with a pretty strong light. And these ones with softer lights or smaller lights hanging where that ceiling fan is right now. Is that it's going to match what we're doing with the room a lot better with the celery green with a gold undertone to it and lots of gold accents, as you can see there with the Moroccan design. And that'll be really pretty. So, backyard, I think. Next, what are you eating? Right now is the part of the day where the dogs like to be out here sunning themselves. Out and do that, and if it's too hot, they come in and take a nap. And we've got the side yard down there with my composter, and then that's the backyard. And as you can see, it's nothing but the dirt. It's just dusty dirt. It's a dust bowl. So our plans for this is gravel over here, a lawn over there, a raised bed garden all along the back. I'm thinking we're gonna have to keep the shed, but if we don't, that's more room for fruit trees. And got this pad to go underneath the kids' play structure, but they sent us mismatched pieces, so hopefully they'll get it back in stock and we can get that going. And then somebody over here is doing construction. Hi. Whoa, look at that hole. Did you dig that or did the dogs dig it? Wow, that one's a deep one.
Very deep.
Well, when you're all done, look at me, Andrew. When you're all done, you see those construction vehicles behind you? Uh-huh. They all go back in the sandbox. Okay, before you come inside. These are our tangerine trees. So under a year old. And then in the side is where we put the sandbox for them. And I'm slowly carting sand from the beach to go in there. And that's into the garage right over there. So let's go through here. The other way into the house, into the living room. And that cactus is probably going to go into storage because I'm inheriting a love seat that's going to go there. And that won't have any room. And I drag these up there. Usually only one has a chip from it. This is interesting. My dog, Leolin, passed away a while ago, broke this years and years ago. And I had the skills, but not the confidence to put it back together and restore it. This since I was a baby. So I'm going to get on that project among the myriads of others that are going on in this house. I like that one. I need to stain that and get the name on that. My dad put together for us. That's my couch. This is the dining room, and it's been our schoolroom since it got too cold outside to continue to school outside. You probably saw all the kids' stuff out there. Like, he's got his easel, and we've got the table, and lots of storage of our supplies there. And much of that has moved in. So we did the 7 days of creation up there, and he helped me do a lot of it. I was really impressed with his artistic skills. So, and then we're working on... We just finished the week of studying the sun. Now we're on a week of studying the moon. Put those words up there so you could learn those. This is what my counter typically looks like. It has a myriad of fruit and always bananas up there. And my blender and NutriBullet and water pitcher. Those are pretty much the tools I use every day, along with this composter over here. This is my juicing pitcher, so when I juice, put everything in there, and the microwave holds the rest of the parts to my juicer, so those are up and out of the way. And not many other kitchen appliances do I use. I've got a pot out to warm up Scotch's food. Every day to pass up warm food. And there's my spiralizer, but I don't use it that much. And then just storage containers. So someday I will have a food processor and a dehydrator, but that just has not happened yet. Okay. Oh, and our flag. We finally have an American flag, so we can say the pledge to the American flag and sing the national anthem every morning before we start our sport. So Andrew's getting good at memorizing that. He also says that all the time in Awana. That's the tour of our home. I hope you liked it. We've got so many projects in the works, and I'm excited to do some DIY videos on those because I know a lot of you are probably going to want to see how it goes, or maybe even try it yourselves, like doing the metallic stenciling in the bathroom. That's going to be a hefty project.
Also rewiring
that fan into a light fixture. That's going to be really pretty, and I'm excited for that. So I will do as much videoing on those as I can to show you guys how it's clean and show you the steps that we took so you can do it yourself if you want to do that. So thank you so much for watching. Hope you have a wonderful day. Moving boxes.